Hey guys, what's up? Today we're playing KONA? Something. We're playing something, that's for sure. I saw this game on Steam, it looked interesting. Let's play. Okay, what is this? I guess I'll pick that one. It's a survival psychological horror game, I believe. I like survival games. I like psychological horror games. Figured, hey, I could check it out, see if it's good, see if it's, okay. It was in early access for a little while, I believe, but it just came out. I know it just got a PlayStation 4 release and maybe an Xbox One as well. Right now, I'm in a car. The sensitivity. And I'm in Canada?
Carl Faubert sought information for a living. That is to say that ever since he returned from Korea, after having served with the armed forces, he had been working as a private investigator in Montreal. William Hamilton, a rich industrialist, had gotten in touch with him regarding a simple vandalism issue. Nothing to write home about. Not worth hiring a private eye either, just so he can drive for hours on rough roads. But that's how it had always been. The client pays, Carl gets it done.
I could drive? Oh, dude, I'm not gonna be good at driving. Where's my GPS? Oh, wait, this
they
is
had
the
set
fucking
up
70s.
The general store, his client's business. Well, actually, the entire village had William Hamilton's name written all over it.
Okay. Siri, where is the general store? Oh, what is that?
When the roads were bad,
driver.
Muddy or snowed in, it was customary around these parts to close them off. But it was also customary to ignore those signs entirely and drive there anyway.
Wait, I gotta walk? What if I get robbed by a moose? I don't like this. And it's saving. Alright, so it's got autosave, which is good. Hold on, let me do something. Oh, what is it? This is an equipment. Flashlight, journal, map, camera. Everything's... I got a D-pad. My Xbox One controller's plugged in, but... I thought for, like, first-person games, it's better to use, just mouse and keyboard. Let's see. I can manually save my game. Graphics option, main menu, controller options. Let's take this down. 25. Yes. Alright, that's... a little better. It's very smooth. I'm getting solid 60. Hey. What is this? It's a flyer for Manistan. It will be good. Alright, I don't want that. But I'm taking it. Oh, I'm not taking it. Can I take that though? I could really use that. Wait, I have a camera, right? Let's see,
Carl, ever diligent in his work, always carried his log on him, in which he scribbled down thoughts and leads alike during the course of his investigations.
Thanks, narrator. That's a flashlight. Wait. That's a map, too, so I don't... Shit, dude.
The
Polaroid, I was gonna
Carl's
take a
photo. Carl's longstanding and faithful ally had seen a share of husbands caught red-handed cheating. There's always something out there waiting to be snapped away.
Okay, so I am armed to the teeth. I'm gonna walk up there, you know, just cause I can. I wanna put that away first. Why does this game remind me of Firewatch? I hope it doesn't end like Firewatch. That would suck. Also, I was reading the description for this game. It does clarify that it does not hold your hand, which was a kind of a... open? Alright, there's bolt cutters, some fire starters, how do I crouch? C. Alright, there's nothing else I can grab in there. C is to crouch, which is nice. I'm gonna go ahead and say this may not be a full playthrough, this may just be like, I guess first impressions. I guess that's the best way to describe it. But... it's a beautiful looking game. I have the feeling that I'm being watched.
Hamilton never mentioned a roadblocking barrier.
That's okay.
Why was it needed here in the back of Beyond? That would, however, be a mystery for another day. Carl had waited long enough for someone to come and raise it. Still not a soul in sight. There was
Can't
no
drive.
Point in waiting any longer. Carl had to figure this one out by himself.
Do I need to
Hamilton
walk?
Hamilton is waiting for Carl in the general store.
The car
time
is running.
For him to get down to business.
All right.
William Hamilton enjoyed a lavish country house built in the very heart of the northern forests, not too far from here. The local populace was divided when it came to the affluent man. Some saw a wealthy philanthropist dedicated to improving the region's economy. Others, an aging Englishman who would do anything to further his fortunes. And those ones hated him enough to go on about scheming against him. Hamilton had recently acquired a few local businesses, but the last straw was the reopening of a mine, which gave rise to a wave of protests and threats from the Cree people. Given these circumstances, Carl reckoned that a good number of people must be feeling compelled to oppose Hamilton in one way or another. So far, only the industrialist's house had been a target, but soon enough, Carl thought, the target would become the man himself.
Sorry, I was distracted by the narrator. Okay, so, Cree, that's Indians, right? Am I stupid? Maybe. Maybe, it's like a demon. An Indian curse. Like a Wendigo. Actually, I don't know. I haven't seen shit, so I'm just gonna assume.
To get out of there. The cold and the
snowed in.
Required urgent care.
So I got driving off. Okay, so this is where the survival part comes in. KONA. Or at least I think that's how you pronounce this. KONA. Alright. 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 Lay chains. Lay chains. Is that so I can drive in the snow? That's really cool. I don't think that's something I really need to... Hey.
Scratches did not stop Carl. His mother would be so proud.
That guy's
the driver
go.
Had taken off. It was still best to check it out and leave nothing to chance. Carl needed help.
There we go. There we go.
It was a small, locked box engraved with the letters WH. Carl thought about taking it.
The heck?
It was to be left to chance.
I'm trying to get in the glove box. There's a thing. I can't get to the glove box. Zoom in? Nope, that doesn't help. I'm freezing.
This
I'm gonna start running.
His last hope was to find an abandoned garage or a farm by the roadside. His life depended on it.
Yeah, I think I might die. There's also another survival game this kind of reminds me of called The Long Dark. I can't walk that way. Nope. Alright.
Carl wondered how long he would have to endure this skin-stinging cold.
Alright, are you just gonna narrate my shit the whole time, bro? I found me a little shack. Alright, you should've just let me die. Alright, heat sources prevent Carl from freezing to death and save the game. When understretched, Carl is less accurate and runs shorter distances. Alright.
Even better than he had hoped. Carl Faubert had succeeded once more, and was now on his way to new adventures.
What's that? I got some matches, I got a fire starter. Is there anything else I could take? A glass jar. Looks like food would be nice. A saw for the bears. Propane tank for the wolves. That looks like fucking drugs. Which I don't really need right now. That would be nice to have to wrap my body in so I don't, you know, freeze to death. Alright, well, I got some stuff to use. Go ahead and save. Yeah, can't save here. That is load checkpoint. Don't want to do that. Okay. I got a log. I got one log. I'm gonna run up here. I know that's kind of dangerous, but hey, you know what? There may be something good up here. I guess I could take these chains over to my car. Nothing's up here. That's not good. All right. Oh, wow.
The cold was burning Carl. He would not hold up much longer. He had to warm himself.
Do I need to go back to the lodge? I'm gonna do that. I'm just gonna chill in here. Close. Alright. How do I... Is it... This, I can use that. There we go, hey! I am heated. My brain is healthy and active. I'm all good. Not sure if I can get hungry or not. Tab brings up camera. Checking. Okay, up here. Doesn't look like I have hunger meter or a thirst meter. I have a health, fire, brain. That's nice. Okay, so can I save now? Now that I got a fire, it's possible to save once you have a fire. Alright. That's cool. I got the chains, so I should probably try to head back to my car, get that started, see if I can get back on the road. Door open, please. Damn it, door! Alright, I'm running back. Taking another log just because I can. Alright, so far it's it's survival-ish, yeah, but it's kind of simple, which is good. Let's see if I can... Does that cover all my wheels or just one? Alright, I think it takes care of all of them. Alright, I'm gonna get the hell out of here. Car's in bad shape, he needs to heal his wounds and warm up before he can drive. Alright, yep, guess I better go back. So I need to heal my wounds and warm up. Alright. Maybe I can try walking over there if there's nothing else to do in here. Okay, tell me how to heal my wounds. Let's see, is there a consumable? Locked iron box. Key is required, alright. Consumable. I got cigarettes.
Carl, like many of his contemporaries, felt like he had more trouble breathing when he wasn't smoking. Cigarette. Was his own personal breathing assistant.
Okay. My health went down. So shit. Damn, is there anything else? I feel like I should, get something out of the rations. Space just saved the game, I guess. Is that seeds? I don't know. Don't really see anything I can eat around here. Let's see, inventory. You got a log, polaroid film, matches, a pincer, which I guess is Canadian for bolt cutters. Consumable, I just got cigarettes and a locked iron box. Can't really do shit. Flashlight, camera, map, and journal. What's my journal say? Okay, the crash. I've already written that down. Awesome. I'm gonna run outside because I don't see anything to do in here. Also, this door's a little weird. What is this? I can start a fire out here. That's nice and cozy. Can I close it? Nope. Alright. We got a fire start. I wonder how long the fire lasts, though. Alright, doesn't look like this leads much of anywhere except for over here. Alright, okay. Take another log with me just in case. I'm gonna try heading back now. smoked, stood by the fire. What if I can walk a good bit now? Alright, I think I'm getting further than I did last time. Nope, it stopped me. Okay. I think, let me go check and see if I have anything in the glove box in my truck. That won't let me in there. I should at least turn it off. Alright. What about the car? Is there anything over here by the car that I need? Aha! I got a first aid kit. Okay. I'm gonna head back to my good old fashioned hunting lodge that I just commandeered for myself. I'm gonna patch myself up and figure out my next plan of attack to deal with, you know, the wreck. There we go. Close, please. Thank you. Alright. Let's see here. Would it be in a consumable? Yep. First aid kit. I'm healed up. I'm warmed up. Narrator, do your thing. Everything's good except my brain. Okay. Isn't the fire what brings the, I guess calms him down. Calms good old Carl down. Like, I can see my legs, which is a plus, you know? There. Guess I head back to my car now? The game saved. Head back to the car. Oh. Okay, I thought I saw a face. But it was the logs. Alright. The door's a little weird. I don't like the door. Oh, hey car. Before leaving, Carl needs to explore and leave nothing behind. What do you mean? I need to leave nothing behind? Are you talking about that? I can get it now. It's a picture of a woman. That's it. Can I leave now? I'm not taking a photo of that stupid car. I'm gonna leave. Alright. Okay, so that's some of the no holding your hand shit. Alright, I'm not driving right now. He backed up himself. Alright. I guess they don't trust me to back up. Okay, guess I'm gonna go to the general store now, or at least try to. Also, where the hell did all of this snow come from? It was a nice day before this shit happened. What does that say?
Spread out on a few acres of untouched forest.
I don't want to get a crash.
Bellowing caribou, everlasting snow, and undefiled lakes. The Manistan region was no tourist hub.
Okay, losing frame. Oh my god. For millennia by holy shit. That was major frame loss.
The industrial era by the
right, but it's back to normal now. There's a lot of houses around.
The truck was running on fuel. Good thing that the general store was close by.
Okay. Loading now, I hope. Not touching anything. Oh, shit. Okay, touching things now. That was a little hiccup that I did not enjoy. Doesn't look like anyone is here at all. Okay. Don't have a key for that.
Something fell to the bottom of the box.
Hey, buddy.
Carl had no trouble recognizing his employer. He had been killed, there was no need to be a detective to figure that out.
We don't know he's
but
dead.
Only a detective could have noticed that the killer had to have been very close. That the fatal blow had been given before the victim even realized.
Say cheese. I do like how I can see the photo. I'm gonna keep that. Alright, pal.
Carl felt a chill down his spine and had a terrifying
cover
realization.
You up, I guess.
If Hamilton was dead, then who was going to pay him?
I could just rob this general store. Got an envelope.
What could be inside that envelope?
John Val Montreal.
Carl was taken aback. He knew this address. It was said to be the address of the P.O. box for the Canadian Secret Service.
They have that? Okay. Canadian Secret Service. Cool. Cool. Let's investigate a little bit. What's this? What is this? The place is a mess. Is that my investigative shit? Okay. He also didn't have a car out there. So if a killer came, killed him, he must have had an accomplice? One to drive their vehicle back and one to drive his, I guess? Maybe someone may have dropped him off. Some broken glass on the ground. Maybe someone was robbing the general store and he just, you know, got in the way. Let's see, what we got over here?
An explosion suddenly occurred outside.
Okay, well that shit can stay outside. Also, I have a flashlight. Oh, what the shit? Okay, I'm looking at the map. Hey, I was trying to get the flashlight in a better position. No thanks, I prefer my beer cold. If you think that's warm beer, let's throw it outside for a second. Everything's gotta be a little chilly in this place. I'm going to take one. Can I please take one? Stop it. Nope. Thank you. Can I take that, please? I am having trouble grabbing that. There is an obvious dot on there, meaning I should be able to. But I can't. Alright. That's a little annoying. If I need gas, I guess I could do that.
Carl knew that Gilles Lachance was in charge of the general store. That made him one of Hamilton's employees. A very angry employee, as Carl could plainly see.
You know what, Hamilton? I have a frog in my throat. When people have a frog in their throat, they do not take risks by going to work. Customers can catch it, right? I'm a wise man, not to worry. I'll have a nice doctor's note, which I'm going to get right now. Sadly, in the meantime, I'll have to close down the shop unless you'd like to come fill in for me. I wouldn't dare advise you, after all, after you know how it's done. As sincere as you are now, with kind regards, your dedicated manager, Giles. Cool. Okay, well, Giles. What the shit happened? Alright, so. There's no one to run the shop today. Giles came by. Alright. It's a little creepy right now, I guess. My flashlight doesn't really help much. When all it does is just look at the map. Alright, to open cash register, punch the price, two numbers minimum, press sale, turn the crank two times, punch the machine if it doesn't work. What the fuck? I was trying to read the note. A secretary wouldn't be a luxury here. Quebec's Klondike. Oh, that's how you use a flashlight. Okay, I was pressing two. Alright, let's see what's up with this thing. It's usually what they do in the movies.
The note explained that the garage and the store couldn't be supplied with electricity at the same time.
Alright, I'll head back. Fuck you. Open. Oh, sorry. Close. Alright. There's wolves out there. Those are not friendly. Let's see. I cannot save it. Okay. Awesome. Don't suspect I'll die out here. That would be shitty.
Carl was no electrician, but he could identify a wiring problem when he saw one.
There's something in the shed. There we go, just throw that in there. Alright, it's saved. And I need a key. Alright, we're gonna do this hunting shit in the next episode, alright? What the fuck is this?
Carl was used to strange phenomena. But a chunk of ice like this? As if an iceberg came out of the ground? That was a first.
What's that red thing at the very bottom? What? What is that? Anyways.
Prince? Carl found a surprise at every turn. Was the camera faulty, or was there a possible lead?
Oh, so I wasn't crazy. Alright, the game just saved. I'm gonna go and end this episode here. I'm probably gonna do a few more episodes on it if it, it's not bad. It's a little different, I guess. Really, once you fully, like, get shit done, I suppose. Which isn't bad, don't get me wrong. But we'll see how it goes. So thanks for watching this episode of KONA. I might see you in the next one. Have a good one. Bye-bye.